I'm Air Force Master Sergeant Mike Skaggs, and I'm a certified fitness instructor.
And we're here to get you fit for duty!
Woo! A show by the military, for the military, and for anyone else who wants a hardcore workout. Prepare to sweat.
On today's program, we're going to focus on circuit training. Circuit training is a great workout when you just have a little bit of time and don't think you have time to get to the gym. Today's workout, we're going to show you how to get your cardio and strength training done all at once. You ready, guys? All right, let's march it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. A little warm up here. We're going to get that heart rate slowly elevated. Get our bodies ready to do this intense exercise program. Let's add some arms. Let's take it up and down and up and down. Up, down, up, down. Up, down, up, down. Now out front, back. Large muscle movements. Get the blood flowing through all of our muscle groups. And get ready for exercise. Feeling good? Heart rate getting up just a little bit? All right, we're going to change up the movements a little bit. We're going to march it out. We're going to go back with the left, up with the right leg. Back and up. Back, up. Back, up. Back, up. Back, up. Back, up. Back, and up, march it out. Now, let's do it with the other leg. Back with the right, up with the left. Go back, up, back, up, back, up, back, up, back, up, back, up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, march it out. All right, we ready? Heart rate up a little bit. All right, let's start this thing out with some upper body exercises. We're going to hit the mats and do some push-ups. All right, around, let's go. We'll start out with 30 seconds of push-ups followed by 30 seconds of cardio. Let's go down and up, down, up, down, and up. Nice flat back. Elbows at 90 degrees. Down, up, down, up, down. How we feeling? We got about 15 more seconds. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Let's go. 3, 2, 1, to your feet. Let's go quickly. Let's run in place. Now we're going to do 30 seconds of cardio here. Then we're going to go right back into a strength exercise. It's 30 seconds of strength training followed by 30 seconds of cardio training. So come on, move those feet, guys. We got 15 more seconds. The heart rate's getting up now, right? All right. We got 5 more seconds, then we're going to get on the mat. We're going to do some negative count push-ups. That's where we're down on the 3, up on the 1. Let's go 3, 2, 1 on the mats. Quickly. Up in that position, follow my count. 1, 2, 3, up. 1, 2, 3, up. 1, 2, 3, up. 1, 2, 3, up. Nice flat back. Elbows at 90 degrees. Up. 1, 2, 3, up. 1, 2, 3, up. We got about 10 more seconds. Up. 1, 2, 3, up. 3, 2, 1. On our feet. Let's go. Let's go quickly. Let's side to side. Let's bounce it out. How we doing? Good? Heart rate's up, right? All right, 2 chest exercises. We're going to follow this up with some back exercises. Again, we're going to be on the mat. We're going to do belly angels, like a snow angel. Let's finish up this cardio portion. We got 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, on the mats. Let's go. It's just like a belly angel, a snow angel, except you're on your stomach. Feet off the ground, hands up front. Let's go back and up, back, up. Arms don't touch. Feel that in our lats. Back, up, back, up, back, up, back, up. We're getting this down now, right? Back, and up, Three, two, starting to burn. One, up. Let's go. High knees. Woo, working now. Come on. Pump it out. You're up at high knees. We're going to do this for 5 more seconds, and we're going to be back on the mat to get our rhomboids and our upper lats. 3, 2, 1, on the mat. This is a back fly. You're out. I call it like a Spider-Man. Your feet are off the ground, and you're just going to come up, down, up, down, up, down. Good. Up. And down, up, down, up, down, up, and down. Good, up, down. Burning already, isn't it? Up, down. 3, 2, 1. Up on our feet again. Let's go. Jumping jacks. Let's get it moving. Let's go up, 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 up. Up. Woo! Sweat is dripping. We feeling good? All right, let's keep it up. We got 3, 2, 1. Let's get on the floor and do some dips for our triceps. Keep those hands pointed forward. You can bring one leg over the other. Elbows only bend. Don't let the butt touch. Let's go down. Up. Down. Up. Good for our triceps and our shoulders. Up. Down. Up. Up, good. Come on, 15 more seconds. What do you guys want to do for cardio? Power jumps? You can't run away. I'll tell you what, we'll run in place. Go 3, 2, 1, up. Let's go. Run it out. Come on. It's a fast speed here. You guys feeling good? Feeling great. Come on, we got 15 more seconds here. Let's chop it out. Chop, chop, chop. Like a football, get down. Come on, chop it. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, we're going to get into the push-up position quickly. And we're just going to hold. Let's go down to 90 degrees and let's just hold it. Feeling good? Come on, we can do this for 15 more seconds, can't we? Come on, 10 more seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, up to our feet. Let's go. We'll hop side to side. Let's go. Hop, hop, hop. Woo! I gotta get the sweat off of them. Feeling good? All right. We're going to go into some lower body exercises after this. Do squats. We did our upper body. Now we're going to work on our lower body. We got 12 more seconds here. 7. Three, two, one. Stop. Squat. Butt back. Knees don't go up the toes. Let's take it down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Up. I want you to sit in a chair. There's a chair back here. Up. Down. Up. Just like that. Nice straight back. Make sure that you come all the way back. Sit in that chair. There's a chair back here you don't want to miss. Go down. Up. Down. Up. Keep the weight on those quads. This is what you want to see. Nice weight on the quads. Up. We got 10 more seconds here. Now we're burning, right? Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Into half jacks. Let's go. Up. Now, this is too much for you at home. You can just do one side at a time. As for us, we're going to keep our heart rate up because that's the point of circuit training. Heart rate is always up. You're getting it moving. We got 15 more seconds here, guys. We'll come out of here, and we'll get in some lunges. 10 more seconds. Doing great. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step forward. Feet, toes stay forward. Knee doesn't go over the toe. Let's go down. Up, down, up, down, up. Since we're doing 30-second intervals, we'll do 15 seconds on one leg, and then we'll step back and switch the other. We've got 10 more seconds here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step up, back, switch. Go down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. Good. 15 seconds. Woo! Our legs burning yet? Everybody feels good? Keep those toes pointed forward. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Up. Let's hop. Jump rope. Come on. All right. We're going to take a quick break. You can go get some water, get a towel to wipe that sweat off, and we'll see you back in a few minutes where we'll pick up with some more strength training. Let's go. Good job, guys. Welcome back. I hope you got some water. You're going to need it. Let's pick up right where we left off. We're going to do some cardio because our heart rate has got down. Let's go. Let's jog it out. Come on. That heart rate needs to get back up. You've been taking it easy for the last couple of minutes. You've toweled off. You've got some water. So, like I said earlier, the key to circuit training is to keep that intensity up the whole time. You want to get the best workout possible in the shortest amount of time. Circuit training is the way to go. So we're going to keep this up for about 30 more seconds. Get that heart rate up. Then we're going to finish up with some more lower body exercises. You guys ready for this next set? All right, let's go. We'll keep this up for 15 more seconds. Let's go a little faster. Come on. Come on, 10 more seconds. 5 more seconds. A little faster. Come on. 3, 2, 1. Let's stop. Now we're going to go wide squats. We're going to step out to the right and out to the left like this. Let's go out and in and out and in. Good. Out and in, out and in. Good for your abductors and adductors, those outer thigh muscles. Good. Legs should be nice and sore now, burning. Good job. Nice straight back. Keep that head and neck forward. Come on, we got about 10 more seconds left here. Nice wide squats. Come on, 5 more seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Jump rope. Let's go. How do we feel? Doing good? Good. Come on, we've got 20 more seconds left here. Intensity is up, heart rate is up, we're feeling good. You're not gonna need another workout today. You're getting it all in at once, right? All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You guys aren't gonna like this much. Let's take it into a static squat and let's just hold it right there. We're gonna hold it just like this for 30 seconds. All that weight is on your quads. You make them nice and strong. They should be shaking. 15 more seconds here, guys. You can do it. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Hang in there. Come on, straighten that back up. 3, 2, 1. Let's take it up. Now, power jump. Let's take it down. Up. Come on. 30 seconds of power jumps. If this doesn't get your heart rate up, 15 more seconds. Come on. 10. Good job. 5 more seconds. We can do it. 3, 2, 1. Stop on those toes. Do some calf raises. Don't let the heels touch the ground. Let's take it up. And down. Good job. up, up, and up, up. Good job. Stay on those calves. Do not let those toes touch the ground. The key is keep this calf engaged the whole time. We got 10 more seconds right here. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's jog. Come on. Shake it off. Shoes are heavy, huh? All right. Come on. Just jogging. We got to get that blood flowing back in those quads again. We've been working that lower body really hard. Now we're going to hit our core, our abs, and our lower back. You guys ready for that? Good news is we'll be on the mat for the most part, but we still got to get up and do cardio. So let's keep it up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the mats. You guys like this, right? Let's go. Hands across our chest. We're going to do a basic curl up. Let's take it up, down, up, and down, up, and up, down, up, down. You're on that imaginary string on the ceiling. Don't bend that neck. You're simply rolling the rib cage towards the pelvis. Focusing on that abdominal area. Let's go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. On our feet, let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on, let's jump and jacks. Good. Woo! The sweat is starting to fly again. I got a towel off. You guys are working me out way too hard. Good energy. Come on. Let's keep it up for 15 more seconds. Big body movements. Now, we're going to get back on that mat. This time, we're going to do some reverse curls. We're going to roll our pelvis back towards our rib cage because we're always bending forward all day long. Let's keep it up in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the mat again. Hands behind you, feet off the mat, and let's just take it back. The only thing coming off the mat is that bottom. Roll that pelvis towards the rib cage. These are great because, like I said earlier, you spend a lot of the time bending forward. We rarely contract our rectus abdominis in this direction. So this is good core training for that. Doing good? Good. Come on, let's go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. On our feet. Let's go, let's go. What are we going to do? Dog in place. Let's go. Come on, 30 seconds right here. Woo! We hanging in there, guys? We're doing good, huh? Jog in place. We got about 15 more seconds right here. Back on the mat. We're going to do a plank. We're going to do a couple of static exercises that are good isometric contractions for that midsection. Great workout. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the mat. Almost like that static push-up that we did earlier, except we're up like this, butt off the mat, nice flat back, look down. And you just hold it. You can feel everything shaking, right? Good job. We've got about 20 more seconds, just like this. You guys are doing great. One more exercise after this, and then we'll start our cool down. I know you guys are happy to hear that. Come on, 3, 2, 1, on our feet, let's go. Let's hop it side to side again. We're just bouncing it out, keeping that heart rate up. We are doing awesome so far. To those of you at home that are following along, hang in there. We're almost done. I know it's tough, but you're doing great. Let's go, 15 more seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, on our backs. A little different here. I want your feet off the floor and your chest up, just like this. And we're just going to hold it. Good. Feel good? 20 more seconds. You should feel that right in here, right in your abdominal. Keep that head up, chin out of your chest. We got 10 more seconds. Good. Good job. Good job. Well, you guys are really sweating. You're making me look good because I'm making you sweat. Let's hold it here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on our feet. Let's go. Come on. Start our cool down. Let's march it out. Now, we're going to continue to move. Let's reach across behind that elbow. Give a slight pull on that shoulder. You don't want any pain here. You just want to feel a slight pull. 2, 1, switch. Keep those feet moving. 2, good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We'll switch it to a tricep stretch. Around your back, up, over, and around. Now, take the march down just a little bit. Just barely moving your feet. 3, 2, 1. Switch. Woo! The heart rate coming down. A little bit, the sweat will stop a long time after we're done working out. We'll get there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, let's take it down. Hold out front. Reach as far forward as you can. That's good. Now, drop your palms. Let's take it down around behind our back. Reach around. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Big step forward. Toes forward, heels on the ground, torso upright. We're going to feel a slight pull in our back calf muscle. Step it back. Thanks for joining us for today's workout. As you can see, we got our cardio training in, our strength training in, our flexibility training in, all in a short amount of time. So when you don't think you have time to go to the gym, circuit training is the way to go. We get all the components in at once. We'll be right back after the break on tips on training smart and staying strong.
I'm Commander David Keblish, orthopedic surgeon and team physician at the United States Naval Academy. I'd like to talk with you today about anterior knee pain, also commonly referred to as retropatellar pain syndrome or patellofemoral pain syndrome. These conditions are some of the most common reasons why we see patients in the orthopedic clinic. Patients will frequently describe pain beneath and deep to the kneecap in a chevron distribution in the front of the knee. Now, the vast majority of these patients won't relate a history of trauma. It's not as though they fell on their knee and contused their knee. Rather, this is just a slow building overuse phenomenon. It's frequently aggravated by activities such as stair climbing, squatting, heavy lifting, or prolonged sitting, for example, in a movie theater or a crowded airline seat. Pain upon rising from this we even call a theater sign. Now, patients with retropatellar pain syndrome or patellofemoral pain syndrome, for the most part, don't need surgery. Stretching is the mainstay of treatment. Start by stretching the calf muscles, posterior leg, both with the knee fully extended and with the knee slightly flexed. We should take this to a stretch of the hamstrings group. I like to put my heel up on a rail. This might be a bit high for me. I like to stand with good military posture, my hips and pelvis straight, my toes to the sky, my hands on my proximal thigh, and slowly, while thinking about where I'm feeling the pull, and working the entire length of the hamstring group from my rear end all the way to the back of my knee, slowly working out to my toes. It's not a race to touch your toes. We're trying to get a complete, slow, long hold stretch. Don't slouch your pelvis forward and slump like this. If you tilt your pelvis forward, you're cheating and it makes it easier. Also, try not to let the knee rock up. Tilting the pelvis forward and flexion of the knee are signs that your hamstrings are indeed too tight and need to be stretched better. Okay, so straight pelvis, straight knee. Now, after I've done a hamstring stretch, I like to go to a groin stretch. And after my groin stretch, I take it all the way back around to a quadricep stretch. When stretching the quads, get your heel to your butt, arch your back, and you should feel this stretch from the thigh all the way up across the anterior capsule of the hip to the rib cage and in the chest muscles, really, across the abdominals into the ribs. Now, I'm arching my back and dropping my knee, really trying to get a good full stretch. After I've done this for a while, I also like to do an abdominal crunch, which tilts the pelvis forward and gives a good deep stretch to the central quad. The quadriceps pulls to extend the knee. The hamstring has to relax to allow that extension to happen. If you go through life with tight hamstrings, you're just asking more of your quadriceps patella tendon mechanism to achieve the same goal, that is knee extension. So stretch those hamstrings. Tight hamstrings are a killer for people with anterior knee pain. And with that, let's train smart and stay strong.
Thanks for joining us for today's show. We'd like to thank the Bowling Air Force Base Fitness Center for letting us use the facility and the fitness team, Adam, Jordan, Torin, and Steve. And join us next time as we get you fit for duty!